been slaughtered, never knowing the reason why. But whoever treasures freedom, like the swallow has learned to fly. How the winds are laughing, they laugh with all their might. Laugh and laugh the whole day through, and half the summer's night. Dona,
and that was a live performance from 1972 of Donna Donna from Mary Hopkin. Interestingly enough, Mary was one of the first to sign with the then new Beatles Apple label in 1968 with the song Those Were the Days. And it was Apple catalogue number 2. I wonder what number 1 was. Email me, Nick Bannister, plaintalking@secklowsounds.org, if you know the answer, for a shout out on next week's show. You are listening to Secklo Sounds on the interweb at www.secklosounds.org. And just a quick shout out to Amanda Pooling over the pond in Pennsylvania, US of A. Hi Amanda, and thank you for listening in. I then went on to ask Nikki what she had next in the pipeline.
Well, I'm just about finished plotting the Wimer sequel, which is a working title is Jean, because it's his adopted son takes on his work. So I shall be busy for about the next year writing that.
I expect you've been inspired by other people and novels. So when you are travelling, what do you take to read?
I have 200 books on my Kindle that are unread currently. I've loved a couple of authors recently. Hilary Mantel, for instance. Wolf Hall and Bring Up the Bodies. Gorgeous historical fiction. She is writing just at a level completely beyond what I can do at the moment. I read her books in awe. Sherry Tepper is another favourite author. Louis McMaster Bujold for her characterisation. Ariana Franklin, there's a 12th century series of a woman doctor, which is a lovely twist, called Adelia Aguilar that I'm reading. Now, I read everything I can lay my hands on.
I guess this all feeds into the writing process. They are mostly historical novels. Do you have other genres you like to read for a bit of light relief?
Oh, well, Sherry Tepper is actually science fiction, which is my other huge, huge interest. I have about 1,000 science fiction paperbacks, as is Louis McMaster Bujold, actually.
As we were nearing departure time, we just had time for some listener questions. Jay from Milton Keynes asked Nikki, do you have any literary idols you hope to meet? And have you met any famous novelists through your writing or archaeological work?
Georgette Hare was my history teacher at school, so I've not only met her, I've had my finger shaken at her. I've also met Louis McMaster Bujold, who is a lovely, lovely lady. I would kill to meet Hilary Mantel. Her scholarship and her writing is just astonishing.
We have a question from a namesake of yours, Nicola, also from Milton Keynes. She's asking, when you go on holiday, do you take your metal detector with you?
I wish I could, but for most countries, as in fact in the UK, you need to have pre-agreed access rights from the landowner. And also in some countries, metal detecting is illegal except under the supervision of an archaeologist. So, no, the metal detector stays at home.
And I guess you want to get away from it, really, if you're doing it most of the
time. Well, I don't know about that.
Faye from Thurston is asking, do you embrace social media very much? Facebook, Twitter, that kind of thing.
Yes. Now, I had an account on Twitter years and years ago and never did anything with it. And then just in the last, 9 months to a year, I've started to become active on it. And I've decided I absolutely love it because I've discovered lists. So I have a historical authors list that I hang out on. I have a writing craft list that I hang out on, an archaeology list. So definitely. And Facebook as well. I have author pages for both Wimer and for Henry. And of course, I also have an Amazon site under Nicky Moxey. So yes, I'm into social media in a big way.
But at this moment in time, you don't see the need for a dedicated website for your work. You're using existing social media such as Facebook and Twitter.
I am, yes. Blogging is something I'm going to get round to do at some point, honest gov, but at the moment it just feels like taking away time from other activities.
Well, Nicky, it sounds like your plane is now boarding, so I'm afraid you'll have to go. Thanks very much, but now you had better catch your flight.
Okay, thank you very much, Mick.
Thanks, Nicky, and have a great flight. As Nicky disappears through the departure gate, we can listen to her final music choice, which is Canon in D by Johann Pachelbel. After Johann, we shall end with one of my favourite tracks. And here is a little competition for you. If you know who the artist is, please email me, plaintalking@seclosounds.org. There will be a shout-out next week to the first correct answer. Thanks for listening, and until next time, goodbye. been listening to Plain Talking with your host, Mick Bannister. In the departure lounge was Nicky Moxey, author, amateur historian and archaeologist. Join me next week where we shall have more scintillating chat with one of my guests from the world of film, theatre and literature. To contact the programme, please email plaintalking@seclosounds.org. Until next time, goodbye.
MK Pulse proudly sponsors Seclo Sounds. MK Pulse is Milton Keynes' local magazine, bringing helpful information on food, health, fashion, money, travel, culture, and much more to 66,000 readers every month. Plus, news, views, and what's on from around the city. If it's happening in Milton Keynes, it's in MK Pulse. And it's available online at www.mkpulse.co.uk. MK Pulse and Seclo Sounds, the heart and soul of the city.